Hello and welcome back to Move 365. This week we are going to do All Request Week. So these are things that people have specifically asked to see. Remember to go to the bio, click on the YouTube link to watch the full length video. I have here my own children's cot that I have resurrected for this purpose. Richard wanted to know, how do you pick up babies and young children out of a cot without harming your back? Well, my kids are 21 and 18, so I wasn't going to try and lift them out of this. I have, however, dug out of storage my very own Womble. This is Orinoco. I'm sure those of you who are familiar with the Wombles will recognize him. And he is going to substitute for a baby. So, as we have said in numerous videos, when you're bending, lifting, pushing, pulling, the pattern of movement that you're looking for is a squat. You keep this little hollow shape in your lower back, try and keep your chest open, broad across the collarbones, spread the collarbones, and your movement is a hinge around your hips. The knees will be bent as well if you keep those soft. So, how are we going to put Orinoco to bed? Facing the cot, you're going to turn about 45 degrees to the cot, and you want to keep the weight of the child as close to your body as possible. So you split the feet apart, split the step, and sit into your hips. And at some point, you're going to have to lean over. This is not ideal. If you can brace yourself against the cot, if it's up against a wall, then you can use the cot in order to take some of your weight as you hinge around the hips and put your charge down to bed. And coming back up out of that position, don't just think, oh, the weight's gone, I can just come up any old how. Try again to keep the same hinging going around your hips. So keep the chest open, lift the head and shoulders first, and up you come. And it's just the same in reverse when you lift the child out of the cot. So 45 degrees or so, you can brace yourself against the side of the cot, then fabulous. Hinging around the hips, reaching down, gathering up the child. Even once you've got the weight in your hands, think, where is the rest of my body? Have I rounded over a little bit? Can I lift my chest up, lift my head up, hollow my lower back a little bit, and then bring the weight into your body before lifting up again? Thank you, Orinoco. I will be here every day bringing you better health through good movement. Questions, comments, please put them in below. We'll see you tomorrow.